Good afternoon, welcome to JCB Lakes for the final of the Angling Times Mandarin Clubman Supercup 2008. I'm Richard Grange, I'm the match editor for Angling Times. I'm also the man that looks after the running of the competition. It's been going 8 years now. It started back in 2000 when we had around 150 clubs entered. It's up to 350 now. They're across the country. They all start in January, fishing knockout competitions against teams from their locality. A lot of the lads know each other, so it adds to the rivalry. They get through two rounds, fish through winter and spring into one of the regional semi-finals, fished on commercial fisheries, North Midlands and South. From that, the top seven are here at JCB Lakes for the culmination, really, of a year of club fishing. One team today will be crowned champions. They will pick up the Super Cup, and they'll be basically the best club team in the country. But it won't be an easy task, because we're spoilt these days with commercial fisheries that 100-pound weights bites off every peg. These lakes aren't like that. They're tough going at times. I mean, some lads today will be fishing for probably three or four bites, but because the lakes hold big fish, that could be 40 pounds. They could come in the last hour. So I'll give you a little bit of background about the lakes they're fishing first. I'm standing next to the North Lake, which is the biggest and perhaps the most prolific on site here. Its main species are carp. They run up to 20 pounds and they average 5 or 6 pounds. So it doesn't take long to put together a weight. Main methods really on here are generally distance feeder and lead fishing, but today it's bright, it's sunny, it's quite flat calm, and quite a few fish being caught on the pellet wagger today. You can see them in the slack water cruising around up in the water. So lots of wagglers out today, and pole shallow as well. So, but some fish being caught on the lead too, and there'll be some on the pole later on as they come in down the edge or at closer range. So you need an angler really that can fish a lot of methods on here. Now, in contrast, the South Lake, which is just a bit further along, there is no carp zone. There's bream and tench and roach, and that's it. And that is an out-and-out feeder job. Very long cast. You can see the islands here. They're a good. Some of them are 90 yards away. And a man that can hit that spot every time will catch more fish than the guy that can't. So accuracy, distance are vitally important. And you're not looking at as big weights off the South Lake. Probably 40 pounds will be exceptional. 10 pounds could be very good on there. And small skimmers, small tench, the odd better bream. So you want a good tip man on there. And then finally, they're fishing the Woodseat Lake, which is used to be a canal, which has been dammed off. It's chock full of features, lily pads, reeds, and so on. And there's small fish in there, crucians, skimmers, small tench, roach. A very good small fish angler will do best there. So you don't want a team of carp baggers, really. Your six-man team, you'll need blokes that can fish a number of methods and are adaptable, especially. And they're the teams that do well. Now, today, the winners last year, Hemsworth Angling Centre, they're here again. They've been pretty impressive in qualification. Probably would start as favourites today. But it's going to be very difficult to tell who's winning and who's leading, because no one's really bagging up and no team is catching well, and they all play the cards close to their chest, and they'll have an idea when they get back to the social club HQ afterwards. But while the match is going on, it's difficult to tell who's leading it individually. In fact, we're probably looking today at 70 pounds to win, maybe 80 pounds, could be a little bit less. But four or five guys are admitting 6 or 7 carp. They're a decent size, some running to double figures, so we've got a couple of hours to go now. They're well on their way. On the South Lake, it's fishing that little bit harder. It's not classic bream fishing weather, so you can't expect a great deal off there. But it's not an individual match. They've basically got to make sure in their 21 peg section that they finish certainly in the top 10, ideally in the top 5. 20 points today would be a bit of a disaster, very hard to overcome, but we shall see how they get on. So, see plenty of methods today, plenty of different baits. Some of it's very much like specie carp fishing big leads and popping up baits and so on for the carp. And then there'll be some classic bream fishing on the South Lake and quite intricate pole fishing on Woodseat as well. So you've got to know what you're doing. I think those teams that are putting time practicing down here in the run-up to it, they'll prosper best. But I wouldn't like to say who's going to win. And just speaking to lads before the match, they're unsure. So we've got 2 hours to go now. I've got an idea of who's doing all right, but the last hour, those big carp will feed on the North Lake. Sport picks up on the South Lake as well. It could all change. So we'll know a bit more in a couple of hours' time.
Wonderful.
Shaking hands from the president.
Yeah. Here we go. That's lovely. Keep it there. Fantastic. Big smiles for me. There you go.
Thank you.
speech outside.
Okay, so that's the culmination of the 2008 Angling Times Supercup. We've had 5 points cover the top seven. It's the tightest I can ever remember it in the 8 years we've been running. Hall Fish Trades have won it today. I think the fish are absolutely spot on there. No fantastic performances, just solid all the way round. And that's the art of team fishing, I suppose. So they'll be back next year. Hopefully there'll be hundreds of other teams. We're trying to emulate them.